The new London Arena in Docklands is a purpose-built community sports centre, concert hall and conference venue, say its owners, and it's costing £26 million. And with an interior of 10,000 square metres, seating 12,000 for a concert, it's the largest arena of its kind in Britain, they say. What, say Wembley Arena's owners? Well, the one in Docklands may be a shade bigger inside, they ponder, but Wembley now seats 12,500 people and will seat even more once its £10 million refurbishment is complete by the summer. Maybe, say the London Arena people, but ours can mount virtually any sports event of any size in the world thanks to our special multi-purpose synthetic floor. Perhaps, say Wembley, but we can already do ice and water shows, horse shows and circuses and sports events too. And, they say, because we're near three motorway exits and the North Circular with two tube stops, buses and our own British Rail stop, we're easier to get to as well. We have the Docklands Railway nearby, say the London Arena people, and buses too. And if people drive here, we have up to 6,000 car parking spaces around too. Say Wembley, we have 6,000 car parking spaces of our own directly adjacent. And Wembley's chairman told me he'd give a pound for every one over 2,000 the other lot have.
What they do or don't claim is up to them. They're very bold to make any claim at this stage. We have just been selected the world's number one venue. We didn't get that by sitting back on our haunches and letting people get away with things. This arena was designed by a genius in the 30s and is, in fact, a model of its kind for the world to work with and see. The improvements that we have made in the last few years have added to that and added to the way it can be used by the public and by the performer.
Why do you think they should prefer to come here rather than Wembley?
We're open 364 days a year. This is the biggest community and sporting centre ever to be built in this country. We want to root ourselves in the community. They want to be members of it. We want them in every day. We want them doing different kinds of things, as well as providing first-class entertainment for them. That's what we've got to offer.
And that's what Wembley doesn't offer, in your view?
I don't think Wembley can stay open after the show.
So, there'd appear to be quite a lot weighing on Luciano Pavarotti's broad shoulders then, because he's the show they're talking of. Be that as it may, in the long term, the public should benefit by having two arenas, of course, and in any case, having Luciano Pavarotti coming to London to sing in June, however he does, can't be bad.